your share. And if you get afraid again, I'll be there. We are a family, like a giant tree, branching out toward the sky. We are a family, we are so much more than just you and I. We are a family, like a giant.
Hey Closeteers, I'm back. It's Jackie. I know I've been gone forever, but I have a really, really good excuse. You just have to listen. Are you listening? Are you really listening? Just listen. All right. Well, yours truly has been in and out of hospitals for the past, I want to say, 3 weeks. So can you forgive me? Okay, enough of that. Let's get on to this week's topic. This week's topic is a lot more serious, and it's about family and family rejection, denial, disowning, stuff like that. Now, I hope that family members of LGBTQ are actually watching this, because this is really important for you guys to hear and not so much for the person coming out to hear. When someone comes out to you, it is a giant leap of faith and trust. And there is nothing that hurts more than your family looking at you and saying, no, you can't be like that. You're disgusting. Get out. Leave. Don't come back. Those words hurt. An example of a really bad experience was my girlfriend, Jamie. Someone told my girlfriend's family that she was gay when she was 15. Her family, in turn, kicked her out of their house, and she ended up living on her own since she was 15 with her own apartment, with her teachers from school giving her rides to school, helping to pay her rent, helping take care of her, all because she was gay. Now, I'm not saying you have to agree with everything that your kids do, but to disown a child is so mentally just, it's just draining. To look at people that you've trusted your whole life, who've raised you and taken care of you, and then have them say, I don't want you here because of who you love, it's pretty fucked up. It may be against what you believe in, but you had this child. They are your responsibility as a parent to look after. And just because of who they love, you're going to just discard that responsibility. That makes you a bad person in my book. How would you like it if you looked at your family and said something to them and they had just gotten rid of you or rejected you or made you feel like you had to change yourself around them? It doesn't even have to go as deep as kicking you out. It can just be the mere rejection that destroys a person. Like, as you can see, I got a haircut, which I don't really like, but whatever. But Jamie got a haircut, and it was shorter than usual, and she was stressing out because of her father and what he was going to say. I cannot imagine living in a place where I'm afraid to cut my hair just because it would look more gay. So family, here's a PSA. If your child, your niece, your nephew, your whatever comes out to you, don't react with hate and with contempt and with an unaccepting hand. Instead, realize that they're still the same person that they were before you knew. If you didn't know before and you loved them to death before you knew, then why do you care? It just drives me nuts when people all of a sudden completely change their point of view about someone just because they're gay. Just because I'm gay, it doesn't make me who I am. It's a part of who I am, but it doesn't make me a different person. I was lucky enough to have a mother who said, I want you to love who you want to love. It doesn't change who you are. I want you to be happy, and who made my father realize this too. But families, disowning people destroys them. Rejecting them destroys them. Pushing them away and denying it destroys them. You're going to put out the fire that's inside of every single person by extinguishing their self-confidence. accept your children. Love your children. It doesn't make them any different. You're only gonna hurt them. And as for anyone who's afraid to come out because of family or has come out and has had a bad experience, this is all I have to say to you guys. Be yourself. Love yourself. No one else's opinion is needed. It doesn't need to be something that gives you the self-confidence to rule your own life. Love yourself and realize that your opinion is the only one, especially about yourself, that matters. You are who you are. You're always going to be who you are. And the more you try to cage who you are, the more miserable you're going to be. I learned it. I'm sure many others have learned it. And now it's your turn. Be you. Be yourself. Do what you want. Act the way you want. Be with who you want. And anybody who has a problem with them, fuck them. See you next week.